Welcome to the terrain and site plan video for the Chief Architect Bachelor View Project. In this video, I'll cover the process in creating the site plan, importing a photo of the terrain, adding the elevation data for sloping the lot, and then placing the landscaping items. Now for the site plan in the project, I've already started. I've placed the roads and I've also placed the lot and a setback. If you look at my requirements off to the side of the screen, I have a minimum 15-foot setback. There's a 12-foot slope that will go from the front of the lot to the back of the lot. And then I've got the designation of what the elevation is, 3820 at the front, 3808 at the back. If you take a 3D view, right now I've really only used the road tool and the CAD. There's not an actual terrain. If you don't need an actual terrain, you can simply draw the CAD lines in here like I've done, and then you've got your site plan completed. Many of the site plans you'll be using may be coming from a surveyor. Surveyor files can be easily imported using a DWG file, and we have a process and a nice video on showing you how to do that. If you're using an image, maybe you got it from the assessor's database, you can then import that. And I'm going to show you how to do that. You could trace over it. It's going to give you a very close representation, not as exact as a surveyor file, but let's look at that. And then I'm going to build the terrain and show you how to slope it. Now I've opened up an image, a photograph, so to speak, of the assessor's plat of this lot. And you can see the dimensions on it. You can see the slope on it. You can import this as an image. Let me show you the process. I'm just going to close this. I actually have this open on a second screen, and all I'm going to do is drag this image over into my floor plan view. Let me zoom out just a little bit and let's slide this over. And it looks very similar to what we already have in the site plan. Let's go ahead and zoom in on this. You're going to notice along the bottom that it's 182 feet. I can use the point-to-point resize and scale this image in both directions. While the image is selected, notice that in the bottom of my edit menu is a point-to-point resize. So I'm going to come over, I'm going to click on this tool, I'm going to click on one point, I'm going to move over to the other point. The program is going to prompt me for a distance. I'm going to put in 182 feet. Notice that the retain aspect ratio is checked. Go ahead and close the dialog. I've now scaled that image. It wasn't significantly off, but I've now scaled that image, and I can trace over this lot and use that as a good foundation. Let's go ahead and slide back over to the actual lot itself. And what I want to do is I want to actually create real terrain and then show how to slope it. The first thing I'm going to do to make that happen is I'm going to change my toolbar configuration to the terrain configuration. When I click this, you're going to notice that my toolbar really kind of changes mainly on this second level. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use this create terrain perimeter. Until you have a terrain, the roads or any terrain features that you have will not show up unless there is actually a terrain. And typically when I create a terrain perimeter, I create it very large, far beyond the lot extensions that I have, because it will show only if the terrain is beyond those components. Let's go ahead and create this create terrain perimeter. And you notice that it comes in at the full length of the screen that I had or any of the objects that I have. And I'm just going to kind of come in here and just make sure that it's a little bit larger than the components itself. Now let's go ahead and go into our 3D view and take a look. Now you can see the terrain came in, it's flat, you now see the roads, and now I have something to work with. The first thing that I'm going to do for this terrain, this house has a foundation that is suspended or hung, and I'm going to move this terrain up so that it supports a flatter entry into the house. Let's click on the terrain, double click to open it up, and I'm going to come in here and I'm going to remove this automatic designation for the subfloor height above the terrain. Let's make the adjustment. Instead of 22 1/4, let's make it 8 1/4, and then we'll be able to see how that terrain then adjusts tighter up to the house, and then I can get a much flatter entry into the house. Now for sloping this terrain, I'm going to use a few tools. You can find points and lines. I tend to just use elevation regions. If you looked at my original terrain modifiers, you have a slope right in here. I'm probably not going to trace over that because as you place the house onto the lot, you're going to be doing some modifications. So I typically won't trace those existing lines using that terrain line tool, but I'm going to use terrain modifiers and just set the elevation of it. As I mentioned, we have a slope of 12 feet from the front, really beginning right here, down to this area right through here is 12 feet. So here's what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a terrain elevation region. You're going to find this tool for modifying your terrain, and the one that I prefer to use mainly is the terrain elevation region. Now with this tool, I'm just going to come in here roughly and shape the terrain, and I'm just going to draw it just past the road. And notice that I'm going past the terrain perimeter itself. And now I'm just going to kind of shape this slightly around the road. So I'm going to create a couple of breaks to create this shape. You'll find the break tool down in your lower edit menu, and you also can use the number 3. You see next to my hotkey as I mouse over that, the number 3 on the keyboard, and I'm just going to create a couple of breaks, and I'm going to slide this up so that it's approximately in an area that I'm interested in. I'm not going to worry too much about being exact. I'm going to create another break over in this area right here. I'm going to pull this up, maybe shape it a little bit, and then one more break right up in this area. And then I'm just going to pull that up near the front of the house. And then we'll slide this one over to the front of the garage. And then I'll pull this one back just a little bit so that it's right in this area. Now that's pretty close. The first terrain region, if you open this up, will come in at the level of your terrain. Notice that the elevation is at 0, and that's the relative terrain. This will be flat at this point. I'm going to draw one more terrain elevation region. Let's come back over, use that same tool, the terrain elevation tool. With the terrain elevation region, let's come over, and I'm just going to draw an approximate shape right in this area. And then let's go ahead and open this one up. In this case, I'm going to set the terrain elevation to be at about the bottom of the floor. I'm going to set this to be a -135.875, which is the bottom of the basement floor. Again, the area is flat inside this elevation region. And then I'm just going to do a little bit of shaping. It's important not to have these terrain elevations overlapping as they are right now. But I'm going to go ahead and shape this just a little bit. Again, using the number 3 on my keyboard, I'm going to create just a couple of breaks in here. I'm going to pull this down and shape it. Maybe another break right in this area. And just shape it around until I get to the right. So we'll pull that over next to the retaining wall on the inside. May need to zoom in here just a little bit to make sure that we're getting what we need. I'm going to have that just snap to that retaining wall. It's difficult to see that in the plan view. And then pull this down. I have a couple of markers here to help me. Now when you create a 3D view, the terrain will automatically generate for you, and you can see that it's sloped around the house pretty well. And that 12-foot drop along the side of the house has been pretty smoothed out just using two terrain regions. You can see over in this valley over here, it's actually pretty smooth. It's a fast way to show your terrain. Let's go back into the floor plan view, and when you do this, you're going to see the terrain has actually been generated with the contour lines. You'll see their negative numbers. I usually like to suppress that. You can actually get to that inside of the terrain. If you come over on the contours component, you can remove highlight negative numbers. Now it may be that you want to show the actual sea level terrain. At the back we have 3808, and at the front we have 3820, a drop of 12 feet. If you want to show your contours down here in sea level terrain, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to open up the terrain perimeter. I'm going to add 3820 in feet. to the terrain parameter, and then I'm also going to do the exact same thing on both of the terrain elevation regions. So we're just going to come in here and put in 3820 feet, and then the last for the bottom one, plus 3820 feet. And then we'll come back up and regenerate our terrain. Once that's generated, zoom in a little bit, you can now see that the terrain is now displaying using the sea level data. Now if you look at the image that I have on the screen of the completed landscape, there are a number of tools that you can use to create the pool and the fencing and all the landscaping elements. I blocked that and added it into my library. Let's go ahead and open up the library. I'll show you the process of adding that in the landscape and swimming area on my library over here. I've simply created this landscape, blocked it, added it to my library. Let's come over and place it. I'm just going to place it off to the side. And then from here, I can simply grab this. Let's change our view to the landscape view. This will be a little easier. And then I'm just going to simply slide this into place to be approximate. If you want to zoom in a little bit, I know that this patio lines up, so I could click on that architectural block and use the point-to-point move tool found in the lower edit menu. Click on the paver area, come over, snap on to the patio. I'm going to unblock that landscape, and then when you go back into your camera view, you can see all of the landscaping components that we added in, including the distributed plant beds. That concludes the terrain and site plan video for the Chief Architect Bachelor View Project.